discussed?
Two layer
of the skin. What are those?
Epidermis
and dermis. What are the different layer of epidermis, Elma? Very good. First one is?
Corneum.
Then lucidium.
Dium.
Lucidium. D-I-U-M.
And then, what
is
the
called? Granulosum. Granulosum. Spinosum. And basal. Fine? So the names are very difficult that you people are facing. Pain to learn it is not like that. Which one is left to be learned?
Granulosum.
Okay then. Now today we'll discuss and the two layers of the dermis.
Papillary
and reticular. And now today we'll discuss third layer of the skin, that is hypodermis. Hypodermis is also known as subcutaneous. Corium. But today we are discussing hypodermis. So hypodermis is also known as subcutaneous because in this layer subcutaneous fat is also stored. So it's the lowermost layer of the skin. And what are the function of this layer? Yes.
This
layer is also known as superficial fascia. Why? Because it connects the inner layer, it connects to the muscles and the bone. Hypodermis is known as subcutaneous and also known as superficial fascia because it connects to the fascia of the bone and muscles. Whatever the underlying bones and muscles are there, this layer connects with it. No, it's having subcutaneous fat. And the function of the subcutaneous fat is to keep the body warm. And of course, the fat is the source of energy also. At the time of emergency, at the time of need, it converts into glucose and provide you energy. So, means it acts as an insulation. It keeps the body warm. And of course, because it's a thick layer, so it acts as cushion also. So these are the major basic part of the point related to the hypodermis. And now today we'll start derivative of the skin. So for this hypodermis is also known as subcutaneous layer and then also superficial fascia because it connects to the fascia of the skin and muscles. And its function is to keep the body warm and also provide the energy at the time of emergency. Yes? And now, derivatives of the skin. What are the derivatives of the skin? Derivatives of skin. What are those? Hair, Nail. Sweat gland. Sebaceous gland. Mammary gland. And these glands are exocrine gland. What are the exocrine gland?
Having duct.
Releasing their secretion on the surface of the organ or on a specific organ. Endocrine gland, they release their secretion in the blood.
Directly
is released in the blood, and blood carried wherever it is necessary. So means like endocrine glands are the ductless gland, and what we are talking here, they are having ducts. So now today we'll start with here. Yes, stratum basal is also known as Malpighian layer.
This is the lower layer of
epidermis. And it's also known as germinative layer also. Why? Because it makes new cells of the keratinized, means keratinization occur because of it. So here, so basically this is the portion in the epidermis, rest in the dermis. Shaft is there in the epidermis and rest portion is there in the dermis. So here it's there in epidermis. It is, and where? Dermis. So here, this portion is hair shaft. Fine. And then root hair. It's hair bulb. This is hair bulb. These are the blood capillaries in this. It's supplied with the blood capillaries. And this portion is known as papillae. Hair papilla. And this hair papilla is basically supplied with blood. Right? So this is the structure of hair. It's the epidermal outgrowth of the Malpighian layer. Outgrowth. From where it comes? Fine. It comes out from the Malpighian layer, because Malpighian layer is the fifth layer of the epidermis. So from there it comes out on the surface of the epidermis. Means the first layer of that is dead layer. And what is that? Stratum corneum. So these are its roots are there in the dermis. So these are also known as pili, and here are flexible strands produced by hair follicle consisting mainly of the hard keratin. They are made up of, that we already know yesterday, means in previous class also I told you that nails and the hair, they made up of hard protein, that is keratin, that gives the hardness or the strength to the nail and the hair. The chief region of the hair are hair shaft, hair root and hair bulb. They are these. So hair shaft is the part project from the skin, and the shape of the shaft determine whether hair is straight or curly. Hair can be straight or can be curly. So this shaft can be straight and curly on the basis of in what type of hair a person has. And then hair root is the part embedded in the epidermis that we already know, we discussed in the previous class. And the lowest part of the hair, root here enlarges into a soft structure. This is soft structure, hair bulb. And the hair bulb is the only living tissue of the hair. Hair bulb is formed in hair follicle. This is the bulges part. This one is the hair bulb. They are attached with the bundle of smooth muscles. Their function is to contract, to keep it erect and to push it in front. Means at the time of growth. There are a bundle of muscles, smooth muscles are there here. It attaches this bulb and the root of the hair attaches to with a bundle of smooth muscles. They are known as erector plate muscles. Erector their function is to push it in front and to keep it on its place. So what is the function of erector pili muscles? What is the function of erector pili muscle?
It attaches to it and it is supposed to make it grow.
And this is also known as pilo erection. Pilo erection. Means erector pili muscles are attached in such a way that their contraction pulls the hair follicle into the upright position. This is known as pilo erection. And its function is to create goosebumps also at the time when a person feels so much cold or fear. Because of this reflex action, these involuntary muscles movement is there in the muscles, and their goosebumps are there. And this is because of the temperature, means when the person feels cold or at the time of fear also. Means like at the time of when the person is in a state of fear, maybe this is a defense system to keep the body, what you can say, in a state of stable condition. So these goose flesh is responsible to cold external temperature or a fear. It is an important heat retention and protection mechanism. Important. You can underline here in your book also. It is an important heat retention and protection mechanism. Hair color we already discussed in previous class due to melanin. And this gray or the white color hair because it loses its melanin. So here from specifically when I started it's going, then itself it is very less chances, but because of some, you know, medication, some medicine, some special type of diet can make again.